This is a chocolate caramel pudding. In some cultures, such as in France, you would call this creme caramel. In Spanish cultures, they would call it a flan. In the United States and Great Britain, we call it a custard. However you call it, it's delicious. But we're making a chocolate version today as opposed to a vanilla version, which is typical. A lot of other flavors that can be used are cinnamon, orange, lemon. It's up to your imagination. But this one's chocolate because I happen to love chocolate. What we're going to need for this particular recipe is 4 small ramekins. This recipe actually doubles beautifully, so if you want to make 8, just double up all the ingredients. I'm going to put those aside for a moment. I have a small pot here and a warm burner. And in here I'm going to put 1/4 cup of sugar, 1 tablespoon of water, and 1 tablespoon of lemon juice. And I'm going to give that a quick stir just to get the sugar mixed in. And now we're going to go onto the burner. And what we want to do is bring this to a boil, and then we want to cook it, watching it very carefully, until it starts turning a light amber brown. Then we're going to pull it off and divide it among these really quickly because this stuff hardens quickly. And then that's going to create our caramel portion. So we just have to wait until this comes up to a boil. And from now on, I won't stir this. I will just swirl it once in a while. So this should take about 3 to 5 minutes. We're very close. The trick here is not to let it go too far. If you let it go too far, you're going to have a very bitter caramel. So you got to really keep a close eye on it. Mine is just starting to turn into an amber brown. Very careful at this point, and also be very careful. This is hot sugar, and this will be a nasty burn. Okay, here we go. I think that's about right. The trick is with one hand you pour, and the other hand you're kind of swirling it around. Try to get it all around the bottom. This one's already hardened. Okay. So now we can put these aside and proceed with the recipe. I've got another pot that I'm going to put on this burner. And to that, I'm going to add 1 cup of milk, just regular whole milk. You don't want to use like skim milk or anything. You want the whole milk. And 2 ounces of semi-sweet chocolate of your choice. This is a dark chocolate bit that I'm using. And what you want to do here is melt this. And that should take about 2 or 3 minutes to melt and blend. All right, the milk is nice and warm, and the chocolate is getting melted. I'm just going to give it a good whisk, make sure that there's no lumps in there. And I don't see any. It smells like hot chocolate. And now I'm going to just pour it into a measuring cup or any kind of bowl or anything. It will cool down faster if you don't leave it in the pot that you melted it in. And I'm just going to put that aside and let that cool to room temperature. So I'm going to put my dishes away, get my mixer, and proceed with the recipe. To continue with the recipe, now I'm going to take another 1/4 cup of sugar and 2 eggs, 2 whole eggs, and 2 yolks, and put them in my mixer bowl. Get them in there. And now we're going to mix them until these are light and slightly fluffy, about 2-3 minutes, not even. All right, our eggs and sugar are a lot lighter, and now I'm going to add the chocolate mixture very slowly because this is still very warm. and I don't want to have scrambled eggs, so I have to put it in slowly to temper the eggs and bring them up to the same temperature. So very, very slowly. And once you've brought the eggs up to the same temperature as the liquid, then you can just pour the rest of the liquid in. We're not doing anything more at this point than just blending it together well. Done with that. Strain it just to make sure that there aren't any pieces of chocolate or anything else in there that I don't want. Just going to pour it into a nice sieve into a container, and I'm pouring it into another spouted container so that I can easily pour this in to the custard cups. Out of the way. And now at this point, if you have an awful lot of bubbles or foam at the top, you can go over and skim it off and get rid of it, because otherwise it will be streaky in your custard. Now I have my oven on at 350 degrees, and I have a pot of water boiling on my stove, because we're going to create a water bath around our caramels so they cook nice and gently. All right, I'm not going to get too crazy about this. If you want to, you can spend more time and really get every little piece off. So now, evenly divide it among the cups. And these cups are not greased or anything. These will come out. Trust me, and I will show you later. These are so, so good. All right, now, I'm gonna get some water. Hold on. And make sure you don't get the water into the cups. Just be very careful when you're pouring. And get it approximately a halfway up the sides of the ramekins. There you go, about there. Now, into my oven, 30 minutes, and then we'll take them out, we'll take them out of the water bath, and we'll let them cool to room temperature. These can be eaten warm or cold. I prefer them cold. Some people like them warm. We'll try them both ways. All right, so into my oven, 30 minutes. Here is our chocolate caramel cream, and I'm about to turn it out. I took it out of the oven. I let it sit at room temperature to cool down for about, I took it out of the water bath right away and just put it on a rack. And then I let it sit at room temperature for about a half an hour. And then I put it in the refrigerator for about an hour. So now I'm just going to run a knife around the edge. And just it out. There you go, and your caramel is all melty. And you don't normally serve this with ice cream or cream. It's just usually just serve it this way. But I thought because it's so brown, we would just put some berries on the side of it to make it look a little bit prettier. And there is your chocolate caramel cream. It's absolutely delicious.